special editions of the Footy Record, highlighted the great stars of the game. None more popular than this irreverent trio of legends. For years, they entertained the football public, even managing to get a few teams to air during their irreverent banter. Last week, they were back together at a photographic shoot for a feature article in this week's Football Record.
Before the judge and the judge said to Jack, "Is that true that you got into bed drunk and was smoking?" You said, "Oh, mate." I said, "No, the beer was on fire."
The repartee was as old as the game itself. The razor-sharp minds of the great men haven't lost anything over the years. The scene was the Sporting Pick studio in North Melbourne. For 10 years, North Melbourne was Jack Dyer's beat when he was a young copper in the Victorian Police Force.
When he got out of the police force, Mick Miller, who was the commissioner, said to me, "Tell Jack to bring back the handcuffs and the bat in his style and the bike. But we're not worrying about this. It's the pup on the bike we want back. He's still got it home now."
Bob, Jack and Lou are a part of football history, just like league teams. According to Jack, there's a simple explanation as to why the show was so popular. And the wise men were John, Robert and Louis. And their judgment was delivered in league teams.
Simply because the men went home, it was late at night, they were drunk, went to sleep on the couch, and the ladies looked at it,
We used to send Cheerios to Yabby Jeans, his wife, and see Yabby, and she picked the side down there for them. And the governor. He had a dog called Rusty, didn't he?
Yes, Henry.
Dusty.
I love those Cheerios.
Yeah.
And after all the clowning around, here's the finished product. Another keepsake in the AFL's centenary year.